X-ray imaging provides us with contrast of internal structures based upon radio opacity. However, this is rarely sufficient for clinical procedures such as interventional angioplasty, in which a clinician is guiding a stent in a carotid artery or trying to deduce flow problems in blood vessels. In these cases, contrast-enhanced imaging via the injection of a tracer is used. In this video, we will look at some of the techniques that are used to generate images that show blood vessel architecture in great detail. In this image, we see a typical DSA image. Like other reconstruction techniques, DSA imaging requires a number of computational steps that we will briefly describe. While these images look similar to fluoroscopy, they are generated by a different technique. In DSA, post-processing with a mask image is performed digitally, rather than via a fluorescent screen. So what does DSA stand for? It means Digital Subtraction Angiography. This is an X-ray imaging technique in which an initial pre-contrast image is subtracted from a post-contrast image. Only parts of the image that are different between the two acquisitions are shown in the final output image. In this example, the final image will only retain the two black structures that appeared in the opacification image. Let's go through each of the steps with a real example. The typical process is first to acquire a normal image, also called a mask image, that we can see on the left. This image is stored in memory, and then a second image is acquired once contrast has been injected. The second image is often called the opacification image. In the simplest sense, these two images can then be linearly subtracted from each other on a pixel per pixel basis to create an output image. In this example, we have used a linear subtraction method, as it is easy to demonstrate. In the real world, X-rays penetrate tissues non-linearly, and in order to compensate for this, we would calculate the natural logarithm on a pixel-by-pixel basis for each of the images before subtraction. This process can then be applied for a time series of images in which each of the subsequent images are processed using the same initial mask image. This process is often used when performing image-guided surgery. In order to reduce noise during a time series of images, it is common to use a temporal filtering method. In this method, only features that are common in three or more adjacent subtraction images are displayed. The main advantage of this method is that it is very effective at reducing the effect of artifacts. A common problem in DSA is when a patient moves between the initial mask image and the following opacification image. This will result in the mask and opacification images being out of alignment. When this happens, a halo-type artifact will be seen on the resulting subtraction images, due to misregistration of the background structures. We'll now see this effect in a real example. Here we can see the halo effect in the upper bones of the hand. There are a few methods to correct this artifact, including automated image registration or pixel shifting. However, a more pragmatic approach is to simply reacquire a new mask image in the new orientation.